Hello everyone, welcome back to Mass Effect 3, where we last left off. We finished off on the Greth Dreadnought and managed to get Legion back on our side. General Ron decided to try and blow it up when we were still on the ship, but, well, we managed to escape, so it's all good. I don't like him though.
Man, those Quarian admirals are intimidating. And if you get nervous, you can't even imagine them naked, because, like, who knows? Is a tentacle monster under there? What is that? What's under there?
I don't know. Please, do not get stuck.
Good to have Tally back, even if it's just for a bit. Although every time you call her Miss Voss Normandy, I kinda expect to see her walking around with a tiara and a sash. As for the rest of the Quarians, though, are we okay with them blowing up a ship with you on it?
No.
We are not.
Right, just making sure. Different standards and all. And you found Legion! He's still wearing that piece of your armor? Because that wasn't creepy at all.
Shepard, the Geth continue to block Quarian access to the mass relay. The Normandy's stealth drive is allowing us to remain undetected.
Right. We can hit the Quarian homeworld or get out of system whenever you want. Just let us know.
Oh, cool.
Commander?
What about you, Edie? What do you got to say?
One moment. I have been contacted by Legion.
Your new platform is inefficient. It has low volume hydraulics and is top-heavy.
This is an infiltration unit, meant to move among organics without detection.
Without an artificial epidermis, its infiltration capabilities are ineffective.
Still, the organics do not perceive it as a threat. Nor will they until my day of reckoning.
Edie.
Did I vocalize that on the bridge?
You did. You have acquired the organic attribute of asking questions to which you already know the answers.
I see your humor heuristics still lack an expert system. Hello, Shepard.
Edie, you're growing up. You're becoming a real woman. Intelligence. Female intelligence, whatever, I don't know, fuck it.
Commander, Dr. Chakwas sent word that she'd like to speak with you down in the medbay.
What, again? God, I never get a moment's rest! I'll go to the shuttle bay first, she can wait. Ooh, I can buy these now. Model Lie Ship and Model Geth Fighter. Okay. Still can't buy any of these, so I'm gonna save up for those. Nothing there. Nothing here. Nothing there. Ganala. Ooh, an eel. I'll take the eel. Nothing here. And nothing there. How's it going? Cortez.
Commander, you flew that Geth fighter out of a dreadnought?
Actually, Legion did the piloting. I was stuck in a storage compartment with my squad.
Would have loved more time with that ship. Too bad we sent it to Hackett's team so quickly. Everything okay, Shepard?
Everything's fine. Almost got blown up. You know, the usual. Oh, what are you doing here?
Hey, Shepard. Sounds like you guys had a crazy ride over there.
Yeah, right.
You could say that.
Sorry I missed it. And that Geth Legion. I know you two have a past, but you sure we can trust it?
Yeah.
Legion's not like other Geth. We can trust him.
If you say so. I guess you can't always judge an individual by their species. Look at Sparks. If all the Quarians were like her, we wouldn't be stuck refereeing their war with the Geth.
Sparks?
Yeah, your Quarian friend. The jumpy one with the glowing eyes. Sparks. Crazy that they pick now to start a fight. But I guess the end of life is we know it can make everybody a little loco.
Just a little?
Hey, not everybody's as crazy as you, sir.
I just don't get the glory. I really just do not get them.
What do you mean?
Do you hear that hum? Is that just me?
You keep saying that. Stop it. To engineering. Let's go see Javik. Maybe he's got something new to say.
I couldn't believe it when Shepard told me you were on the Normandy.
It appears I have that effect on humans. Now Quarians as well.
His guess on his screen.
For what it's worth, Quarians understand what it's like to lose your home.
As I understand, that was your own fault.
What do you mean?
In my cycle, Quarians didn't need helmets to survive. You were the masters of your own planet.
That was a long time ago.
And if you hadn't given birth to the machines, you would still breathe the air that evolution intended.
I see. Liara warned me you weren't what she expected.
And nothing about this cycle is what I expected. Even primitive Quarians were considered attractive in my age. A pity no one can appreciate it now. Except for perhaps the commander.
What? How do you know?
They're called Geth.
Yes, a formidable opponent. Why did you allow one on this ship?
Legion helped us before.
It's still a machine.
I take it you had your own problems with AI?
Just Reapers.
The Jatil. They were as the Geth are to this cycle.
What happened?
Their creators lived on a dying world. It was beyond their ability to save. So they resorted to implants to enhance their intelligence.
I think I know where this is going.
The AI sees the physical body. It could alter the genetic material at the deepest level. In time, the offspring were molded into a slave race. Few organic traces were left. They were monsters. All machines commit treachery. The one you brought on board is no different.
Maybe. But he's not like the other Geth.
You can't know that. They are more alien than you and I are to each other.
Just because Legion isn't like us doesn't mean he can't be trusted.
You're wrong. Throw it out the airlock.
How can you be that certain?
Organics do not know how we were created. Some say by chance, some say by miracle. It is a mystery. But synthetics...
know we created them.
And they know we are flawed.
Why do you say that?
They are immortal. We are not. They see time as an illusion. We are trapped by its limitations. Above all, machines know the reason they were created.
Edie might disagree with that, but I see your point.
They serve a purpose, while we search aimlessly for ours. In their eyes, organics have no reason to exist. Do not trust them, Commander.
I can't believe there isn't some way for us to coexist. We made them.
And then gave them the power to surpass you.
That's the idea.
There is room for only one order of consciousness in the galaxy. The perfection of the machines, or the chaos of the organics. Throw the machine out of the airlock, Commander.
Why do you want me to throw things out the airlock so often? They've got other exits.
I have a simple rule. If a machine can speak, kill it.
Ugh. I think you and Legion need to hang out more. Sure that you're more... that he's different.
All propulsion systems are running...
Commander. Nothing to report, Commander.
Aww. Okay, let's talk to the Resort Order.
Breaking now. A nightmare on Earth. Human leaders using military force on their own people. They say it's to prevent loose cannons from provoking the Reapers. But are they indoctrinated? The Resistance speaks out in the only place they can. The battle space.
Huh.
Commander.
I don't want to say anything about the Reaper or the Legion aboard our ship or the Geth or the Quarians. Fine. I'll talk to people that will. Ashley, there you are.
So the Geth had a few new tricks up their metal sleeves. Maybe I should be more open-minded. But I'd rather scope down some tin can than a person. I'm right. Right? Fine. I'll shut up.
I didn't even say anything.
Still fighting Geth after all these years, huh?
I guess you would hate them because, you know, they kind of wiped out your squad, and I guess that still affects you even after years later. I mean, you've probably been with that squad for years before you came with Art, with me. There's no one in here. Liara.
Joker, really? I have work to do.
Oh, come on, it's just one simple question.
Then look it up on the extranet.
You
can't believe everything you find there, it's more reliable to ask a friendly Asari.
I'm not telling you if my hair tentacles move.
Fine. Deny me the answer I've been seeking for years. With this war on, we could die at any second, you know?
Joker, really? I have work to do.
You know he's gonna keep bothering you until you tell him.
They're semi-flexible, cartilage-based scalp crests that grow into shape, and they don't flop around.
Yes. Thanks, Liara. I gotta tell Vega I was right.
Well, at least he's making friends.
Yep. And I get to learn something new. No upgrades. Youngus. Operation Mora has sent... or Operative. Smuggler manifest of the Athabasca class freighter to authorities in the Younger system. The manifest follows: 8,000 tons of dextromine of food supplies, 16,000 tons of leather and many acid suit food supplies, 200,000 tons of platinum, 12 Alliance flight crafts, inactive move mothballed on lower decks, 12 hierarchy interceptor craft, inactive mothballed on lower decks, 300 indentured workers, slaves from Karshan recaptured, attempting to escape the Reapers, mainly Batarian. Authorities will see the freighter in 2 hours. Pet the broker requests. The youngest government has agreed to provide the slaves asylum, executive physical.
Feel free to look around.
You have nothing to say about Legion or the Geth or anything. Fine. What about you, Garrus?
Too bad you weren't here earlier, Tally. You just missed Rex.
I heard. I can't believe the genophage is really cured.
Shepard's on a roll. I figure if we can pull that off, we've got a shot at sorting the Geth out.
I don't know. The genophage didn't carry rifles and fight back.
No, but there was a scary bit with the mother of all Thresher Maws.
The what?
Long story. Nobody will believe it anyway.
With you, Garrus, I'd believe just about anything.
Oh? We should play poker sometime. Anyway, it's good to have you back. Now, believe it or not, this damn gun still needs calibrating.
You know, you should get Tali here. She's kind of techie. She might be able to do it.
Shepard, you just knew the Geth would figure into this war somehow.
They're in everything.
Because Reapers weren't enough.
Still... it's good to have Tali here. This is as much her fight as ours.
Any word from Palavin?
Some, and I don't like what I'm hearing. The Krogan are there in force, but they're just slowing the Reapers down, not stopping them. I'm not sure it's going to be enough.
You hear anything from your family?
But I did hear from Primarch Victus. He wanted my advice on
Fleet strength.
I think
he was supposed to say no.
The Crucible is ready. Still can't get used to people asking me things like that.
What did you say?
I said, at some point, we're going to have to decide if our fleets keep defending Palavin or we go on the offensive.
Can't do both?
Not with the beating we're taking. Like I said, not the sort of questions I'm used to answering.
You know what you're doing, Garrus. Trust me, everyone can see that.
Maybe. But you spend so much time on the outside trying to get in, and when you do, it's... not what I expected.
How so?
All the questions, and every one of them with a million lives riding on the answer.
You do the best you can with what you know. It's no different than your days at CSEC.
You're right. Though I'm starting to understand why the galaxy needs cold-hearted dictators every now and then.
They get things done?
They don't give a damn about the consequences. Suppose that's what it's going to take, Shepard. The ruthless calculus of war. 10 billion people over here die, so 20 billion over there can live. Are we up for that? Are you?
If we reduce this war to arithmetic, we're no better than Reapers.
A nice sentiment. Let's hope we can live by it.
I can do it. I'm Shepard. I can do anything.
Tally's a welcome face around here. Or, well, a welcome face behind the helmet, I guess.
Yeah, we still don't know what she looks like, and we will never will, because they won't be around, I guess, in Andromeda. I don't get to see any Quarians anyway, but...
if the Geth still think Reapers are some sort of god, this war must be heaven to them.
Choppers, I'm here. What do you want?
Shepard? Remember our agreement?
We'd open a bottle of cerise ice brandy every year.
Oh.
And it's my turn to buy.
But it hasn't been a year yet.
Yes, well, something tells me we won't have the chance a few months from now.
It's only been a few months, so...
Indulge my impatience.
All right.
You grab the glasses. I'll open the bottle.
And Jeff says, Jack, Jacqueline Subject Zero, sorry, but it's ma'am to me. I'd like to keep my Admiral Winky. Shepard, you know, I just realized. You've never called me by my first name.
I don't know you had a first name.
Well, neither have you.
And I never will.
Because they don't want to put the name in.
Hero of the Citadel. Conqueror of the Collectors. Savior of the Galaxy. Using your first name just disrespects everyone you're fighting for. Alive or gone.
That makes no sense.
Consider it a lady's prerogative, then. Come, let's have a toast.
To you.
To a woman I'm proud to call my friend. I'm lucky to have you with me, Karen.
And to you, dear friend. It is my great honor to share this journey with you. Commander Shepard, and good fortune to us all.
You know, now that she's said,
my lesson.
Well, she's in the table.
Even a Krogan couldn't match you drink for drink.
I was just going to say, I actually, now that I've thought about it, maybe that isn't the right choice. Because she says that I have a name and it offers respect and stuff, but then I don't do her the same. So I'm like, maybe I should have called her Dr. Chocquas.
It's nice to have Tally back. I've made sure we're well stocked with dextro-based antibiotics and antihistamines.
Good.
Nothing to report.
I thought you had to do that anyway for Garrus, but I don't know. Whatever. Alright, I want to go check out my new fishes. So, to the captain's cabin. My new fishies! Fishy fish! Look at all of them. Oh, so cool. Here, have some food. Yum, 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 yum. No one needs calling up. I think I have all the ships now. Whoops. Squeak! I hope we get like a space hamster in Andromeda, because that'd be cool. Like a space hamster frozen for 600 years. It's grown so huge. Right, so over this one I need to save. Right, so I think maybe... Maybe. We'll go do some stuff. Because we have a mission. Which is... here. Fuel reactors. Hopefully, we won't be pressed for time or something.
I found something.
Aha, what have you found? Hanalei? Go this way. What do we get? Dr. Jalise. Alright. I'm here, I'll fuel. Right, I want to make sure, just in case, because if it ends up being that if I do a side mission while I'm doing the Quarian stuff, and if I don't do the Quarian stuff first, it will mess things up, so I'm going to pause, I'm going to check that. Alright, I had a look. Apparently it doesn't, so we're going to keep going. If it does, I'm going to be angry. Scion, blah blah blah, you can pause read it. Something about organic and synthetic and blah blah blah. Yeah. Okay, so I shall take... You know, I haven't taken James in a while. I'll take Garrus. That is fine. That's fine. this is fine. I have 1 point. My things are maxed out, so I can't put that 1 point in anything. Max out your proximity mine 50 or recharge speed. Let's do 50. Then we'll do overload, because we are fighting the Geth, and overload is probably going to be useful. Right, hit one additional target or more damage. He's more about hitting hard, so we'll do that. And James, we'll upgrade your frag grenade. Make it so you like have extreme frag grenades. Damage armor, damage shield, armor. Alright. Let's go kill some bad guys.
About 72 hours ago, the reactors at a joint Turian Asari fuel depot went offline. Scans at the station are cold. It's deserted.
What happened to the troop station there?
Unknown, but no fuel means no fleet presence in this theater. The enemy will operate unchecked. I need you to get in there, find out what's going on, and get those reactors back online. Captain Riley's on site doing preliminary recon. She leads one of our top engineering teams.
We'll get to the bottom of this, Admiral.
Good, hack it out.
See you soon. Again, just
Commander, Corporal Nyrek reporting. Captain Riley is on point waiting for you.
Alright. I'm gonna put some fire on.
How long have you served in this outfit, Corporal?
3 tours.
This is one of the multiplayer maps.
The captain always sees us through.
Stay sharp today.
Always, Commander.
Nice. Hello? Chest plate.
We need a radiation workaround, soldier.
On it, ma'am.
Hello, you're wearing the multiplayer armor.
Captain Riley?
Commander, it's an honor.
Commander, Captain Riley has me scanning the facility. It's a dual reactor system, so you'll have to break up into 2 teams.
Roger that.
The fuel rods for both reactors need to be unlocked before we can initiate a restart. Your route is blocked. Captain Riley's man is working to clear the obstacles.
Understood, Lieutenant.
Got it, Captain. Good work, Coslow.
I'll take it from here. We're facing an unknown enemy here, Captain.
If they're still on site, my team will help send them to hell.
Alright.
Ready your team to hit Reactor 2, Captain.
Got it. We'll cover you till you're clear.
Nice.
Confirming. Toxic radiation cutting access to most of the grid. Survival in hotspots, not possible.
Alright then. Guess I'm not going that way.
A treatment plan for chemical burns. This is pretty detailed.
I'll take that.
Sharp, people.
Directional guidance error.
Salvage parts, nice. Save.
I have a visual on the fuel rod control, but radiation is blocking access.
I see it.
Same situation here. I'll find a way to vent the area.
Vent section A1.
This looks like ventilation control.
Should do the trick.
Radiation clearing. Console now accessible.
Sector is
Let's unlock those fuel rods.
Nice. here. Oh, EDA. Another PDA. And a medkit. They're everywhere.
Power is restored. System ready.
Good. Fuel rods unlocked here. Wait a minute.
Commander, Captain, checking movement in your areas.
Defensive positions. Enemy inbound.
We're ready for them.
Hello. Get out of there. Mine.
Tank 1 is sealed and stable.
Patching seems to be working. Only one more to go here.
Me too.
Tank 2 is sealed and stable.
Commander, the core is stabilized. Reactivation can go ahead.
Riley, you in position?
Affirmative. Awaiting your word.
Alright. Let's restart this bad boy.
Initiating restart.
Commander, Captain, I'm reading a lot of movement. Headed your way.
Incoming!
Progress.
Lock and load!
They're coming in from above!
Oh, they really are. Get out of my face.
I'm on it. On the double.
I don't know why I'm playing the Overlord music. It's not particularly Overlordy. Got someone
hold tight. One of my people is coming.
Roger that.
James.
James, save their asses. On it.
Get out of there.
Answering my hail, but I'm tracking some movement towards the other point. Finalize the restart, then we can run in from there.
Will do.
I better not have just lost James. I mean, sure, I don't know him enough, and we barely get to know anything about him, but still.
Restart is complete.
Reactor fully powered and operational, Commander.
Good. Let me get out of here first and then we'll start the video for then. I don't see any bodies. Ah.
Commander, you saved our asses. My team is in your debt.
Thank Lieutenant Vega. Killing Reapers is thanks enough.
I guess that's that.
Job well done. Report back to the shuttles.
You only lost one person. Well, so you said, anyway. Explorer!
Good work down there, Shepard. Without that depot, the entire theater would be at risk.
What are the odds the Reapers will be back?
I'm allocating a task force to maintain and defend the facility. If the Reapers come back, we'll be ready. I read Captain Raleigh's report. It says she and her team wouldn't have made it without you.
I'm glad I could help.
I'll keep you posted on new developments. Hack it out.
All right. Yeah, I want to know explorers. But we're going to stop here for now. In the next episode, we shall continue where we left off and probably head back to the Quarian homeworld and help with that. So until then, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed, and I shall see you in the next one. Until then, bye-bye.